United. I'm welcome to my latest video. This one's just a short diet on fitting the basics of surfacing up devices. So basically, I'm going to be going through 12.06s. Captain's just did 805 size, 603, right down to the 042s. And then I'll be fitting an SL8 IC, got a voltage regulator. I've got a SOC 23 there and a couple of LEDs below it. And I'm going to finish the video with this 100-pin quad flat pack, which yeah, I'll show you right at the end in quite fine detail. So yeah, what you need really, a couple of fine pairs of tweezers. I use two different sides of solder for it, different sizes, I'll mention them. And yeah, I'll show you everything step by step, so it should be pretty clear. So what I'll do, I'll get straight on fitting the AI 05s, and hopefully you'll sort of learn something from it, and yeah, hopefully enjoy it. I'm just sort of fitting the first components for the video. Well, all I'm doing is, I'm just going to fit an AI 05 resistors and capacitors to these two positions, so you've got C50 and R82. This is why I like to do it. I know some people basically like to put a blob on one end, and then sort of attach the components to that blob and then redo the other end. This is why I like to do it. So literally, I put a little bit of flux on the pads, so you can't really do this without the flux. And I'll drop the components into position, so you've got your capacitor and your resistor. And what I like to do, I literally like to just tack one end on, because I think this way you get sort of a better feel for how much solder you need. So you're looking for sort of a joint that sort of curves from the top to bottom, like a speed slope. Yeah, so literally I tack them into position, so they're nice and central to the pads. And what I do then, I go to the other end and just solder that properly. So you can put a nice curved joint top to bottom. Same with this one. And then I can go to the first end and revisit that and do it sort of properly, same as the other end. So that's what you're looking for, a nice sort of curved joint. I'll put it clean these up so you can sort of see, see how they are. But yeah, you can get these joints sort of nice and sort of uniform and sort of nice amount of solder. This will enable you to do harder components in the future. So I've got there, I've got sort of a nice sort of curved joint going down, same there. So you've got four nice joints, nice and central components. But like I say, if you can get these joints not bulbous, it really helps you when you sort of get to the smaller 042s and your fine pitch ICs. So what I do, as always, I'll put photos of these up at the end. But what I do now, I'll move on to sort of other components for the video and we'll go from there. So now we move on to some SOC 23 diodes. Basically, I'm going to fit a Z4 and a Z5 in position there. This is literally done the same way as I've done the resistors beforehand and the capacitor. What I do, a little bit of flux again. So it's pretty vital with flux. And what I do, lift the component into position. Again, I don't sort of blob one pad like say, some other people do, but this is just the way I like to do it. So I'll get a little bit on the iron, and I'll normally tack the bottom sort of right-hand corner of these ones. Just put a tiny amount on there. Just to hold it into position, same with that one. So I've got a nice amount on the corners, and all I do then, just get a fresh bit of flux just to obey it all when you're sort of doing it properly. And I can go to the other end first, I'm going to just do this one first. And what you're looking for, you don't want too much on these, you just want, you can even see the outline of the leg and that's fine. So if you can get these nice, that really help you in the future on the fine pitch stuff like I said earlier. I'm using lead-free solder, that's why the joints are a little bit sort of duller than normal. Just, yeah, if they're really, really shiny joints, it tends to be where people are using leaded solder. So what I'll do, just give them a quick clean, you'll sort of see the amount I've got on there. But yeah, like I say, if you can get all these sort of nice and sort of uniform, not too much solder, it will really help you in the future. So as you see, I've got a nice amount, sort of four pads at the front, it's back to the same. And that's basically how I fit my SOC 23s. So what I do now, I move on to some other components and I'll show you how I do them. Right, so I'm quickly going to show you how I do my sort of LED diodes. So basically, same again, put a little bit of flux on the pads. And I'll just lift over the components. As you can see, there's a silk screen dot to this end of the diode. Now normally that denotes the cathode, which is on this particular component, it's the green band. So I've looked at the data sheet. But yeah, some designers have sort of decided to make that the anode, so it's well worth getting a sort of data sheet up to make sure you're fitting it the right way around. And I'll do these exactly the same as I did my R805 resistors and caps as sort of earlier in the video. So I've just got a little bit, just pin them both ends slightly to tack it on. Just don't need a lot really on there. Let me do then. So visit the other end and do that properly. Similar amount to earlier, so you're looking for that nice little curved joint. Okay, don't want too much on these. The same end. You've just got to watch the potted body on the top for each of the components. I'll give that a quick clean. And what I tend to do after, I tend to light them up just to sort of make sure I've got the right clarity. So as always, I'll clean these up and sort of put photos up at the end. Just get a little bit of flux off. So what I do now, just light these up, just prove I've got them around the right way. So as you can see, that matches the dot. And that one as well, so they're around the right way. So what I do now, move on to something else. Right, we're coming now to an SL8 IC, so I'm going to basically fit U3. Now I've changed the camera angle for this, so you're going to get a really clear view of the joints at the front. So basically, what I'm going to do, as always, a little bit of flux on all eight pads. So I've made the camera angle a little bit different so you'll get a real clear view of the front four pins. So what I do, what I do here, same again, I do literally tack any sort of two pads on one on each side. I do one there and one there. So check your clarity, make sure that's correct, because you wouldn't believe how many times I've seen people, even myself, have done that. So now just go around the front four. You're not looking for too much, you just want it to run along the joint and around the back of the heel. So a little bit coming out the back, same there. So you don't want too much on, you just want a bit of nice fillet, sort of a little bit sloping at the front and that runs along around the back. So yeah, literally, I've got a nice sort of joint, you can, as you can see. I've got a nice little joint around the front, sort of down there, nice amount. You don't want too much. And I've got a similar around the back, which obviously I'll take photos after and clean it out, and so you'll see all of them as well. So that's what you're looking for. You're not looking for loads of solder. Just when you get to the fine pitch stuff, this is, you know, this will really help you. So what I'll do, I'll give it a quick clean, and then I'll put photos up at the end, but so that completes the SL8. So what I'll do, I'll move on to something else. Right, so following on from the SL8 IC that I did, which was rather a large component, I'm now going right the other way down to the 402 size resistor. So again, what I'll do, add my flux over all the pads. And what I'll do, basically tack that into position with a tiny amount. So these are really small, so hopefully they're staying to focus so you can sort of gauge what I'm doing. I'll literally put a tiny amount on both. And really central. So these are generally the smallest resistors you'll probably have to deal with. You do 201 sizes, but they're basically not used that too much, so this is the most common small size. So what I do then, go to the other end, and as with all my two-sided components, just add a tiny amount to the other end. That's all you need. I'll show you these photos after, so you get a clear idea of what they finish up like. It might be quite hard from the camera angle, so please bear with me. So that's all you need. I've got a tiny amount there. I'll give them a quick clean up, so hopefully you'll see where sort of better idea of what they look like. Just give them a quick clean. So yeah, always sort of double-sided resistors, caps, sort of any sort of tanks. Always do the two-sided, two-ended components the same way. Just add a little bit to one, tap the other properly. So as you can see, I've got a nice curved joint, sort of going top to bottom. It's the same the other end, might say I'll put some photos up after. So that's what you're looking for on the 0402s. So what I'll put a few photos up, the ones we've sort of shown so far, and then I'll put a few more videos up after them. Right, I started second section of videos with a quite a large voltage regulator, obviously a lot larger than the 0480 before the 4 photo. For fun, if you get anything like this, you can see on this one here, this one's actually connected to the plane all around it, and that's going to make that difficult to solder, because when I see people soldering these, I just get generally a bit run right at the end, but don't really spread across the pad. So what I've done on this one, I've actually, this isn't joined to the plane, but this is just, if you're struggling, this is what you want to do. I've literally tinned this with solder and whipped it all off, so I've got it nice and flat. And so when you solder the end, it will sort of more easily spread under the body and join the pad underneath. So that's a good tip, basically, if you're struggling to get the solder to go beyond to the end, tin it first, whip it off, and obviously it'll make it a lot easier. So what I'll do now, put the component on and I'll show you how to solder it. I'm coming to the first end of the regulator, so what I'll do, as always, a little bit of flux. So what I'll do, I'll slide the component into position. And then I'll sort of get these two generally soldered up. The middle one on this component, middle leg, isn't actually used, so you will find some of these do have middle pin missing. So what I can do, hopefully it's staying focused, because I've got to change my iron bit for this, I've got a rather large one to help with basically aid with the other end. I'll get that central, and then solder these up properly. So hopefully the focus is staying. Hopefully you'll see the amount I've got on these. You just want it to run around the sides, around the hill. So you've got quite a nice amount sort of going up the sides, right round to the back of the hill. So that's basically your first end. So what I'll do now, just turn it round, and I can solder up the other end. So as you see, you don't get a lot of room on these components at the end. That's why if you pre-tin them, like I do a minute ago, it really aids you. So again, a little bit of flux. So when you get a ground plane on these components, you might need quite a large tip. So I've actually got a large tip with a flat side on it. So what I can then do, just turn it around a bit more. So stand on its side, and this, when this takes, it'll go really nice. It just takes quite a while to go. Right, I know, because it's already tinned, that's going to run really nicely underneath. Literally, that's all I've got to do. As you can see, you've got a lovely joint right around the bottom. It's gone really well, right the way along. Spread underneath, because it's already tinned. So that's basically what you're looking for in your regulators. So yeah, if you're struggling, like I say, pre-tin it, and that really aid you. So what I'll do, now, I'm just going to move on to a few components that I've already put onto the board, but they're just more examples of double-ended components, just to see, you know, what a joint's look like. Right, so following on from the voltage regulator, all I've done here, I've literally already sort of soldered these on properly, just to show you sort of what the joint should look like. So yeah, these are basically 603 caps down there. So as always, like you can see, a curved joint down top to bottom. The same the other end. There you've got a couple of sort of 805 resistors, same again. There's a big cap, 1206 cap up there. There's a large tank up there. As you can see, all the joints are sort of generally the same sort of shape. And all I do, exactly the same. All my two-ended components, I do all the same way as in previous videos, no matter what the size. So yeah, that's generally how I do them. So yeah, you know, it's a good method. And like I said, I don't pre-sort of tin or pre-blob the pads like some people do, but so everyone's got their own preference. But this is just the way I like it to, you know, to get a nice joint. So yeah, what I do now, I'll move on from this. And lastly, I'll show you the quad flat pack 100 pin. And yeah, after that, put a few photos up and hope you enjoy it. Right, so this is where we finally come on to the last component I'm going to fix for these videos. This is 100 pin QFN or quad flat pack. Basically, what you do first, basically put it on your pad to line it all up. I've already tacked the pin around the back side in this corner. So what I do, I'll tack the pin on the other side, the opposite side, and then I'll show you how to sort of do the joints. So basically, what I do, you want to beat the solder, sorry, beat the flux around that side. Just put it on your iron, and try to tack one corner on the opposite side to the one I just did a minute ago. So what I do, just tack any sort of pin on this one. So just tack that into position. Then, I can just literally run down the joints from the solder. I don't drag solder like some people, I do individual pins. So what I do, hopefully you can get a sort of picture of what I'm doing. It's quite hard with the camera angle. I can sort of just go along, nice and simple, just feed a little bit in all the time. Doing maybe one or two pins at a time, and that's that side, all soldered up. Got a nice little fillet on every joint, so it's running around the back. And that's as simple, you know, as it can be really. I don't like to drag solder, sometimes I'm a bit worried about pins. So what I do, I'll turn it around, I'll do a different camera angle for the second side, and hopefully go all right. Right, so coming to the second side, so what I've done, I've changed the camera angle, hopefully you can get sort of clear view of what I'm doing. So again, run a little bit of flux along the whole side. And all I do again, is literally get my iron, do one pin at a time. In and out, in and out, in and out. So if you catch two pins at a time, not a problem. I'll get a nice little sort of bead of solder right around both sides of the joint, down around to the back, around to the hill, and that's literally how I do, sort of, you know, basically how I do the second side. It's, yeah, it's a good option. So I like to do pins individually. So, you know, people like to drag solder, that's fine. But at the end of the day, everyone sort of gets a preference. It's just literally the way I like to do it. Right, so now to the third side, so again, just run a little bit of flux all down the side. So do the same as the first two sides, just do each pin individually. I've already tacked one to the corner on this one. So that's all I do, go in and out, in and out, in and out. It's quite a lot longer than drag solder, it's just, you know, I personally find it a little safer. There you go, it's that simple. Right, so finally, we do the fourth side, so again. A little bit of flux. The flux is really important with soldering, you must really use it, just aids the soldering so much, so again, same again, in and out. It's just, you know, it's just a good safe method for everyone really. You can get the object short, but you can easily remove it. That's it, that's all four sides done. So what I'll do now, I'll clean it all up and put some photos up. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed all the videos, and if you did, you know, please sort of like and subscribe. And I'll see you again soon. Yeah, hi, so yeah, basically, just wanted to record this little bit of extra video for this last IC placement I did. Yeah, right at the start of the video, I think I said it was called the QFN, which actually, the QFP, ends like no leads, and this one's obviously got leads, so this is actually QFP. So I just thought I'd sort of correct it, save everyone messaging in. There's just a couple of other little points I should have really said. Basically, if you can get yourself a 0.25mm solder, that will really aid you when you're fitting these. It's available from a company I use called BLT Circuits, based in England. And also, one other thing that is really helpful for this is sort of basically get yourself a small conical tip for your iron. That's what I use. Basically, you struggle with a big tip doing pin by pin. So that's basically another big tip. Just get a conical one and yeah, you'll find it a lot easier. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the last video, and if you did, it'd be great if you could like and subscribe. And like I said earlier, I'll see you all again soon. Thanks a lot.